Hello and welcome. This tutorial demonstrates how to research a PICO question using the SNAL database. PICO refers to a commonly used method of formulating research questions for health and medical research and is an acronym referring to P for patient or problem, I for intervention or exposure, C for comparison or control, and O for outcome. The example PICO question I will be using is from NMDW 221, the effect of a sedentary lifestyle on weight gain and health risks. As a PICO question, it would look like this. In a woman aged over 50 years, that's our patient, does a sedentary lifestyle, which is our intervention, compared with an active lifestyle, which is our comparator, result in weight gain, which is our outcome. To help keep track of the synonyms I use, I recommend downloading the Advanced Search Strategy template found here under Quick Links, Study Skills, and the search strategy is here, and I recommend downloading the Advanced Search Strategy. And here is the example of my PICO search. So as you can see, I've put my question here. I have broken my question down into the main concepts. So my P, my patient, is a woman over 50. My intervention or exposure is a sedentary lifestyle. My comparator or control is being physically active. And my outcome is weight gain. And then as you can see, I have put my patient here, woman over 50, then any synonyms that I think might be relevant, I have put here under the patient. I have done the same for intervention, comparison, and outcome. And when I'm searching, I will search for all my patient terms, then all my intervention terms, then all my comparison terms, and then my outcome terms. And once I have searched for each of these patient terms, I will search for them with an OR, which will broaden my search. And once I've finished all the other searches, I will then search with AND. So for today's example, I am going to be using the SNAL database, and it's available to all Endeavour students through our EBSCO subscription. And SNAL is found here under Databases, all databases A to Z. SNAL is usually found here in the most popular databases, but if it's not there, it can be found under C. And this is the SNAL page. And for this search, I am going to be searching using the SNAL subject headings. And we want to use the SNAL subject headings as they make finding relative items on the same topic easier to find. So I am going to go back to my PICO search template, and the first term I'm going to be searching for is women over 50. And I go here. And I search. Now, it doesn't come up as a main subject heading. It comes up as a keyword search, which is fine. So we will search with that. But when I've looked, I've seen one of my other terms, which is women, and that is a subject heading. So we will come back and search women after we have done this keyword search. So we're going to search the database. And here is our first search. So to keep track of all our searches, I'm going to go here to search history. And there is our first search term, women over 50. So after every search, make sure you clear it. And then we go back to our subject headings and we are going to search for women because that was our next term. And we're going to browse. And there it is as a main subject heading. So I am going to select women and I'm going to search for database. And there is our second search. Now, I'm also looking for middle-aged, and I can find middle-aged down here in Refine Results. So I go down here and I want age. And I'm looking for a woman aged 50. So here she is in the middle age range. So I'm going to select that. It's going to update my search. And it has searched for women. And it's also searched for middle aged. And there's our results here. So I'm going to clear off that search. Now, that is all of my terms for my patient. So I am now going to search using OR. And this will broaden our search. And as you can see, we've got over 20,000 results. So I'm going to clear off that search. And I'm going to look at my next PICO term, which is a sedentary lifestyle. And we've definitely cleared it. We'll go back to subject headings. We'll pop our term in and we'll search. And sedentary lifestyle isn't a subject heading, but lifestyle sedentary is. So we are going to search that. And there's our first result. So we're going to go back to my template and I'm going to search inactive lifestyle because that's my other synonym that I'm using. I am going to clear that, go back to subject headings and search inactive lifestyle. So isn't a main subject heading, but it is a keyword search. So we will still search using that. And there are my two intervention terms. So I am going to clear off that search. I am going to select 5 and 6 and search with OR. And there is my search. So let's clear that. And let's go back here to our PICO search and let's do our comparison or control. And I have quite a few terms here. So this is going to be our longest one to do. So we'll go here. We'll make sure it's cleared. Pop into the subject heading. See, physically active. And physically active brings up physical activity as a main subject heading. So we will search for that next, but we'll search our keyword term first and search the database. And then we will clear it and we will go back to our subject heading and we'll search again. And we will search physically active. We will search the database. And there's our subject, there's our result. And we will go back here to the PICO search and we will select exercise. And we'll clear that off. And we will select exercise and we will search. And we will go back to our PICO search and we will search regular exercise. And we will clear that subject heading out. And we will browse. And it is a keyword. So we will search the database using the keyword search. And we will clear that and we will go back to my template and we will get our last one, which is physical exercise. And we will search physical exercise. And it's telling us to use exercise, but we already have exercise. So we will just search physical exercise as a keyword. We will clear that off and we will go back to our example. So that is all our comparisons or our controls. So let's now do our OR search with our physically active terms. So here they all are. and let's search them with an OR. And so there's our results. So let's clear that off. And now let's do our O, our outcome. So that's weight gain and obesity. So let's see what happens if we search for weight gain. And it is a subject heading. So we will search the database for that. And we will clear it off and we will go back to subject headings. And our last term is obesity, and we will search for obesity. And obesity is also a main subject heading. So we're going to search the database for that as well. And there are our last two terms, our outcomes. So let's select our outcomes and search with OR. Oh, now, I was bad and I didn't clear off my obesity search. So I'm going to clear off this search box and I'm going to go here and I'm going to select my search 16 because I know that's the wrong one and I am going to delete it. And it will only clear off search 16. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to re-clear that search off because I do not want it. I'm going to search my searches 14 and 15 and I'm going to search them with an OR and there is my last set of results. Now I'm going to clear that off and now I'm going to do the AND search. So I'm going to combine search 4, search 7, search 13, oops, search 13, and search 16, and I'm going to search with an and the and is going to narrow my search, and I have 8 results. So at this point, I would sign in and I would save my search. If you don't have an EBSCO account, we do have a very, very good video on saving the EBSCO searches, and that is in the description box below. This concludes our video presentation for today. Thank you for watching. And if you have any queries or questions and you need further help with your PICO search, please book a consultation with one of the librarians. And you can do that here under Ask, make an appointment with a librarian. Thank you once again and good luck with your future studies.